priority valve is another cousin of these. What a priority valve does is it determines priority of the system. So some engineer figured out what he wanted to move first in the hydraulic system. So for instance, some airplanes, if you're taking off and the landing gear is down, it adds a lot of drag. And if you've got your flaps down, that adds some drag, but it also gives you lift. So let's say that we're flying the airplane, we take off, and the pilot puts the landing gear up and the flaps up at the same time. Well, there's not enough hydraulic fluid to move everything as fast as we need to move. So the priority valve, the engineers figured out a long time ago that the most important thing is to get the landing gear up. Because when the landing gear goes up, then we can fly faster. There's a lot more drag. So in that situation, you want the gear to go up first, then you want the flaps to go up. So the priority valve is going to mechanically sequence these two systems, and it's going to ensure that, in this case, the landing gear moves first. So we've got a line from the pump. This is pressure. And we've got a vent line, which will let fluid escape and allow this thing to move correctly. And this spool, this little spool here, will sequence that we get. The way this will work is that fluid will come down here, push this off, and flow to the primary system in this situation. And then after that gets to the end of its travel, it will allow fluid to flow to the secondary. And this is a priority valve. It's kind of like a fancy relief valve is what it's like. Then we have quick disconnects. These are just couplings on the end of hoses. So usually things like service tanks and things like that will have quick disconnect couplings. And you can clip them on and clip them off pretty fast. A couple other types of valves. This is a hydraulic fuse on the left. What a hydraulic fuse is let's say that we have a landing gear, a wheel brake. And wheels are out in the gravel and dirt, and they're down by the runway, and they can get hit by debris, and we can break a hose. So let's say in landing we break a hose to one of the sets of brakes. We don't want the hydraulic fluid all going overboard because we need our brakes. So what the hydraulic fluid fuse does is the fuse senses a lot of fluid moving in the line. In this case, with the brakes, we're going to move some fluid and push the pucks in and stop the wheels. But and that might take something like a quart of hydraulic fluid to push the brakes and compress everything and make the wheel stop. But if the fuse feels 2 gallons of fluid go through that, probably not even that, if it feels a gallon of fluid goes through this fuse, the fuse says, hey, that's too much fluid. And it shuts itself off and stops the bleeding. So what a fuse does, let's look at the illustration on a fuse, if we've got it down here. Well, what the fuse does is it throws a lever when too much fluid flows through and blocks off that port. So that's what that's for. This is a simple relief valve here in figure 12-44. And what we've got is we've got a spring on top. It's adjustable. So there's a pressure adjusting screw. And it pushes down on this ball, and this ball blocks off the pressure port. Now, if the pressure goes up so high that it's strong enough to push the spring, our fluid pressure comes up through the bottom, pressure. So let's say we get a real high pressure, like 3,200 PSI, and we're set to 3,000 on this. This excess pressure will overcome the spring, push the ball up, and fluid will go over here through the return port and back to the tank. That is a simple pressure relief valve. And in this case, it's a poppet type. The poppet pressure relief valve means it has a ball and a spring. Here's a shuttle valve. It talks about over here, if you have more than one system, like emergency system and a normal system, the shuttle valve lets you supply a system with two pressure sources, and then it selects the proper pressure source. So in this case, we have a normal inlet, and we have an emergency inlet. So they're calling it an alternate. So in the first one, we have fluid coming through here normally. So our hydraulic pump is supplying fluid, let's say, to our brakes, comes in here and goes out the outlet. Now, if that fails and we have to go to an emergency system, maybe we have an emergency pump or something. If fluid comes in, if pressure comes in through this alternate, it blows this spring and this plunger back and supplies fluid from the alternate system. So this valve just selects between a primary and an emergency system. It's spring loaded. That's how it works. It's called a shuttle valve. This is a pressure reducing valve in figure 12-76. And so in a pressure reducing valve, let's say we have a 3000 PSI system, but we have one set of actuators down here that operate at 1000 PSI. And all it does is just take the pressure from a higher pressure and step it down. And that's a pressure reducing valve. Here they show us how it works. We have a plunger and we have a relief valve up here. And this is a 100-pound spring in this case. And between it and this check ball here, we're going to reduce the pressure by 200 PSI. That's a pressure reducing valve. So there you have it. Several different types of valves in aircraft hydraulic systems.